Hello, my beautiful fellow human beings. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Christina. Today, we're gonna talk about sex. Actually, no, we're not gonna talk about that. We're gonna talk about your sexual energy. So if you're here for the first part, that's just not gonna work and you can click out right now. But if you want to know how to turn that energy into manifesting everything that you want in your life, then keep watching. Okay, so let's talk about sexual energy. Now, when we talk about sexual energy, oh my God, there's so many things that we can talk about. If you just think about the story of Adam and Eve, right? Let me just quickly explain something before we start understanding how we can use that sexual creative energy for your manifesting. First of all of these stories are such beautiful metaphors. And this is just my personal belief. You can, of course, believe something else, which is okay. But it's quite interesting that Adam and Eve were living in the Garden of Eden where they were not aware of their sexual energy. That's the whole point of the story. And the reason why is because they were living close to God. So they were living very close to oneness. When you are in oneness, you don't understand the law of duality. There's no law of duality. If you just think about Garden of Eden, even like lion was living next to a monkey without needing to feed off the monkey and stuff like that, right? Adam and Eve were not aware of their sexual energy. There was one tree, the tree of knowledge, that had that particular fruit that if you eat that fruit, you will understand what? You will understand your sexual energy. In that moment, when the snake came, which by the way, obviously the snake was a representation of the kundalini power, your sexual energy that flows through all your chakras, all the way up so that the 1000 petal lotus can open up and then you reach the Buddha consciousness, understanding and integrating every part of this human experience, but still honoring your soul and understanding what this life is actually about. We're not talking about meaning of life in this video. We're going to talk about that soon, but let's just talk about how when Adam and Eve actually ate that fruit, what happened? They saw that they were naked. So what does that mean? That means that they were finally aware of their sexual energy. In that moment, they understood that in order to feel the oneness once again, they would have to connect the feminine and the masculine and become oneness. And that would happen through what? Their sexual creative energy, because when you connect, obviously, the masculine and the feminine, you create a baby. Once again, that's actually, by the way, number one reason why people innately feel the need to create children is because they want to feel that oneness, that miracle of God once again. And when I talk about God, I talk about the divine source. You can call it whatever you want. Because the second that they ate the fruit, they became the co-creators also. Now they could create life themselves. Before that, they didn't know about this. And the funny thing is that everybody keeps hating on the snake, but without the snake, there would be no life, really. Without the sexual energy, there would be no life. I wouldn't be here, you wouldn't be here, we wouldn't be talking to each other, we wouldn't be learning from each other. There would be beautiful stillness, oneness, yes, but nothing much would be happening, right? Which is ultimately what we want to reach mentally, what we want to reach in our souls, this feeling of oneness. But we still have to integrate as we go to reach all the way to that level. Your sexual energy, your creative energy is so potent and so vital. You can actually manifest anything that you want with that specific energy. And why is that? Because you, once again, I talked about this in another video, when you take something from the conscious, when it's just lingering in the conscious, that's a masculine energy. And then it's the Shakti, the feminine energy, that actually takes that energy and navigates it all the way to this Maya, this illusion, this reality, this physical high density realm that we live in, okay? So it is that connection. So with that process, you can actually birth anything that you want, but you have to be absolutely aware of your sexual energy. And the issue is that for the most part, we are not aware of how important and how potent our sexual energy is. And we are just what? Wasting it. We're just wasting it. We're wasting it because we're trying to find validation from people. We're trying to find external sources of love. And we're connecting it in our mind through sex, obviously. But the issue comes that just think of your sexual energy as a glass of water. This is your sexual energy. Now, the more that you keep wasting it on things that are actually not important in the long term, in the long run, for your soul's growth, you're left with nothing. You're left literally with nothing, and you're just going to be way more confused about who you are, what your story is, what your purpose is, and how to actually get everything that you want in your life. So let me tell you a little story. When I was younger, I had definitely lots of issues with my own sexual energy because I wanted that validation from people. And unfortunately, we live in a society where the construct of how we treat each other is not necessarily healthy, actually rather the opposite, because women are trying to seek validation through very negative fantasy ideas that are reflected on us through certain movie industries. And men don't understand how important it is for them to keep this vile energy within them, because men are ultimately the ones that actually physically give away their energy when they are wasting it. And on the other side, women are the ones who are actually absorbing it. Now, I keep seeing more and more people, especially men, that are actually holding off right now. And of course, society is still divided. Some people are laughing at them. I ultimately feel that it's a great thing to actually be aware. I always say that the person who is actually aware of their sexual energy and wants to step back is the ultimate winner. And the reason why is because when you actually are not connected, in this sense, you're not triggered by other people's validation when it comes to your own sexual energy, you can preserve it and you can internalize it in a way that now when you hold, this is the most important energy there is universally, this creative energy. When you know how to keep it in and not just give it away to other people, you can do anything with it, because then your cup is still full. It is still full, okay? So I want you to just understand this one thing and think about it in a sense that I have my cup full. Where am I gonna give this creative energy? And guess what? I'm gonna say something that you will probably not like, but this is the truth, and I know it from my own life. When you get out of the cycle of I want the validation from another person through my sexual energy, let me just show them how amazing I am in bed and stuff like that. What happens is when you start preserving your sexual energy within, things start manifesting way faster, because you can flip this kundalini energy inside, which can be active or inactive. Usually it's not so active. We're not aware of our energy. Not many people still have been through kundalini awakening. It's a very intense process. But even without this happening, that energy is still within you. It will be forever. You know, you can't escape it, and it cannot escape you. You are merged together. When you become aware of this and you actually you stop playing the game of the validation through your sexual energy from an external source, and you just honor the sexual energy within you, in other words, you stop doing the one night stands, you stop sleeping around with people that you know are not going to be your lifetime partner, and you just relax and you just sit, there will be so many things that you can do with this energy. When you start manifesting, honoring this energy, the sacred energy within you, things will manifest so fast, because that energy is connected with the universal creative energy. So if you actually know so if you are willing to step out of that cycle of what majority of our society plays right now, and you just step back and you think of yourself as I am this vessel of such powerful, potent energy, things will start manifesting much faster, much faster. That means that you can't be triggered by certain things anymore. And every time you feel triggered, you can just take a step back and then ask yourself, do I want to waste my sexual energy on this, or do I want to preserve it so I can be more vital, so I can have more energy, so I can manifest things that I actually want in my life? So this is absolutely important that you actually do this step and that you understand this. And then once you know this, you can actually just feel the energy, because when you feel yourself, you are the creative energy yourself, right? You are the miracle of creation yourself. And this energy flows through you every single second, every single breath that you take. So when you understand this and you're not giving that energy to somebody else, but you're collecting it back, whew, in that moment, if you try to manifest anything and you connect it with other methods also, like for example, the bounce effect method, which I talk about somewhere in here, you will manifest everything extremely fast. Extremely fast. Try it out. Let me know how that works. Yes, it requires some discipline in your life, but I'm sure that you can do it. If what you really, really want, what you really, really desire is worth it for you, then you will definitely be disciplined. And I would just try it for the sake of knowing whether actually it works or not, but I'm quite sure that it will work for you because it worked for me. It worked for many, many people. And when you stop playing this game of chasing and hunting and stuff like that, and you just understand that everything that you already need is within you, it is game over. And then you become the ultimate winner of your own life, and you will manifest anything that you want. And I really, really want that for you. So thank you so much for watching. And as always, I honor your time so much. Thank you so much for being here with me. And until next time, light and love. See you soon.